Good morning, everybody. Jim Chester here, live from the Berkshires Philosophy Event 2018. I have a good friend here, Steve Tullius. He had the opportunity to present to the group 2 days ago, and I just want to say thanks for joining us today, Steve.
Yeah, thank you, Jim. It's good to be here.
So tell us a little bit about what topics you covered.
So I spoke mostly about finding our voice. You know, in chiropractic, many times chiropractors find it hard to find their voice, especially when they're going out into a community that doesn't understand chiropractic, or at best they have this idea that chiropractic is about back pain and neck pain, and at worst they think we're quacks and not real doctors. And if you go on and Google chiropractic is, to put those two words in, you'll see what comes up on auto search, not on Google and Yahoo, Bing even, for those five people that use Bing. And it's chiropractic is bullshit, chiropractic is a scam, chiropractic is a joke, all these things. And if you type in chiropractors are, it's a whole lot worse. And so I believe that chiropractors need to know that. And in schools, the students, this should be shared with them so that we can start building them up to be prepared to share this message and not allow the opinions of others sway that message that they have an obligation to share. But even beyond that, I shared an image of Dr. Mildred Krevlin. She was one of the 700 chiropractors who went to jail so that we could be here today talking together, and so that each of us out there can provide an adjustment to the people we serve in our offices and communities. And obviously, they would not have gone to jail for the treatment of acute low back pain. And so for all those chiropractors out there, you know, and those chiropractors that want more for their practices, that don't want to be attracting these musculoskeletal cases constantly. I hear this all the time from docs. You know, that's not what they want. They want to be seeing the miracles again. They want to get the sick well. And that was the next message. We need to get back on track as a profession. We need to get back on track and getting the sick well and helping them stay that way. And so helping them share that, we talked about the number of sick people in our country, the number of kids sick, you know, with autism rates now 1 in 36, 1 in 27 boys. OCD affects 2.2 million children in this country. Autoimmune diseases, you name it, mental health issues. I was at a mental health parent support group a few weeks ago. I was asked to go to this, and 30 parents are sitting in this room sharing their stories about how their children, two daughters diagnosed with bipolarism, two daughters, this one woman has that she says she lost count of how many times that they tried to kill themselves, and I sat there through this, and I have personal experience with my own son's story and his experience, and so, I sat through that hour to listen to him, and when it's time for me to share my story, I cried from a place of as a parent who had suffered and going through that, but also because I felt the burden of needing to help save these lives of these people. And guys, doctors, out there are so many people, that was a room of 30 people. That's just one community and so many other parents that aren't even showing up. They're alone. They're waiting for an answer. And I shared B.J. Palmer's last words from The Glory Going On. There are multitudes of people seeking what you possess. And so I spent the last 5 years of my career shifting my message, shifting the focus to put out there a strong message of vertebral subluxation correction by letting people know that it's so much more than musculoskeletal treatment for all these conditions. So that's what I shared. That's my why of being here this weekend.
So I know you said something right there about helping communities. What is the major project that you've been working on that you're getting chiropractic more entrenched into communities?
So I started delivering a presentation in my community called Unraveling Neurodevelopmental Disorders. And that presentation was created so that I could bring people to me, have a room of parents, because I, at the time, my son had such intense issues that I could not go out and market a new practice in a way that in the traditional model with spinal screenings and things like that. And so I created this presentation, and then I, through trial and error, discovered a formula of how to put people in the seats, through Facebook advertising, and then created the follow-up systems with email autoresponders and all the content, and packaged it together at the request of a friend, Dr. Sean Carey, who we then tested in his office, and now we have that in 60 offices throughout the country, changing lives, helping doctors save these lives of kids and families, and helping get chiropractic back on track to helping the sick get well. And we took the success of that, and we, with the help of Dr. Bruce Steinberg, created the Mental Health Matters program, which is now there for, you know, to help people with anxiety, depression, PTSD, and within the chiropractic framework of not treating these conditions, but in a salutogenic model of helping them understand that it's healing from the inside out by restoring the mental impulse and allowing for the body to heal on its own. And now we have a gut-brain connection workshop. Another. So these presentations are now in over 100 offices, and they are shifting the practices. They're shifting the lives of communities, and the goal is to have it throughout the world. And I'm excited. In my own office, we do them in Spanish now, too. We're going to be going into the Latin American market as well, so I'm super excited about it.
No, you know, honestly, coming to an event and being able to be around such high-level thinkers, and, you know, I think we're shifting this whole paradigm of what chiropractic really is. So when you start talking about these psychological concerns, when you start talking about these developmental concerns, when you start talking about, you know, the traumas that are inside of the body that the chiropractic adjustment helps release, it gets me, like, excited for the future of chiropractic. And let's touch a little bit now on the Berkshires. Mm-hmm. And why is it so important for people to come out here? And what's the outcome of what we do here?
You know, I never miss the Berkshires philosophy event. And the reason I never miss it is because of it's a movement. It's not an event. It's a movement. It's a movement of like-minded individuals, chiropractors who want to help get chiropractic back on track, not only in their offices, but for humanity, with the big idea of what chiropractic could do if it was applied in the way it was designed to be applied. And so, you know, it's a, you know, all the proceeds, Dr. Scott Garber and his wife Marguerite, they put this event together. I think it's their ninth year. Every year they give the money back to chiropractic. All the money, you know, they've set a model for the profession to look at and say, this is what we all should be doing. And they give back all these proceeds. Over $100,000 have been given back to chiropractic because of their efforts to do so. And this weekend, they gave Scotland College of Chiropractic, which is going to be starting in 2019. Doctors, please, you know, give from your heart's abundance. We need to support these schools and these new colleges that are desperately needed throughout the world. It's not just the U.S., guys. We need to have a vision much greater than ourselves. And so I think it was $4,000 donated to Scotland College, Oklahoma. I think it was $7,000 that was donated to Oklahoma Children's Center, where Dr. Bobby Dosher has been helping these children heal for decades. You know, and so we need to. What it's doing is it's bringing chiropractors together, and with a mission of growing ourselves, getting back on track, and serving the profession and giving back to the profession.
Yeah, you know, honestly, I look at the Berkshires as one of the largest philanthropy groups out there. Plus, you get a chance to come here and get your CEs and get dipped in tick.
Absolutely, yeah. We just heard some phenomenal speakers, you know, the entire weekend, and get your CEs. It's a no-brainer. And so next year's event is March 21st through the 24th back here at the same location. You can actually register now if you go to tickevent.com. Registration is open. I'm going to register as soon as we're done here. Every year I'm registered to come back. And that's the other thing. The speakers all come here. They pay their own way. They pay for it because they want to give back. You know, it's not, you know, sometimes speakers, they, well, okay, what's in it for me? You know, and that's not what this event is about at all.
That's cool. So if people want to jump on board and get involved with the programs that you help do, how can they do that?
So you can go to chiropractic.com/workshops. We're currently, we're not in open enrollment right now, so there's a wait list to get involved with that. But you can find more information about those three programs there or contact me directly. We typically open enrollment 3 to 4 times per year to make sure that we take care of those clients and give them absolute best service possible.
Well, Steve, thanks for sharing with the audience today about what you have going on and what happens here. I think it's absolutely amazing that we can connect out here and we can share the big idea with everybody out there that's not here so they can get a little glimpse of the magic that happens out at the Berkshires.
Thank you for being here so we can share with you out there today.
Yeah. So I just want to say, everybody out there, thanks for joining us today. And if you didn't make it to Berkshires 2018, just like Dr. Tullia says here, you can go ahead and put that on your calendar and come out here 2019. And maybe you can see all these awesome people that are experiencing this beautiful weekend out here in Massachusetts. And with that being said, you're just one story away. Keep hustling. Thanks, Steve.
All right, thank you.